let me say, it's for mentioned principles of giving the land back to the people. Swanu was established for self-determination of the Namibians. And we did not deviate from that, and we are sticking to that. We feel that the 29 years or 30 years of independence so far has not delivered what the Namibians aspired for. Namibians yearned for complete independence, complete transformation of this society. But this is not what we have witnessed. We see a lot of poverty, a lot of landlessness, we see a lot of homelessness, we see a lot of crime, which in Swanu's dispensation thinks that will be alleviated or if not eliminated, because Swanu wants to have a complete transformation of society so that our majority people also enjoy the wealth of Namibia. Namibia is an extremely wealthy country and the population is very low. Hence, we in Swanu believe that it is manageable. All Namibians can feel happy under our dispensation, and we don't need to have Namibians living in corrugated iron sheets, which are very hot in summer and very cold in winter. I think better houses can be built for the population in all the areas, in all the towns. So, and it's also very important for value addition for our minerals, so that we have some of the mines even maybe closed down. I don't think we need 5 uranium mines at the same time in Namibia. We can close some of the mines for the future generations. And of course, we are for training of the Namibian people. The youth must be employed. Vocational training has to be emphasized so that the youth can employ themselves and also be employed by other sectors and so on. We need a competitive, universal, free education that will be subsidized by the government, as well as actually universal socialized health care for Namibians. I actually despise some of the parties, especially the ruling parties, calling names of other parties and individuals. I just gave an example during the launch that the genocide of Rwanda came about because of one president having called other people, the Hutus, cockroaches. So this name calling should end in Namibia, where some presidents here in Namibia referred to people like Judas Iscariot or Bet X? That the defense minister recently called rotten eggs. How can people be rotten eggs? Those remarks can easily lead to, or in fact, when you go back a bit even, there were others from the ruling party who claimed that other parties will bring back the Caspers and things like that. And I think the cockroaches issue was also used in Namibia. So those remarks are very bad for calling other people, because then they fuel cockroaches and don't deserve to live in a free Namibia, which is not the case.
What do you say to critics that apparently Swanu is a party of old people and they don't have any agenda for young people, and it's also apparently a party aligned to one tribal or ethnic group?
That myth is already shattered by my being Tangeni Cornelius Kakweno Iijambo Ovambo, Oshiwambo speaking person, who is leading this party at the moment. Let me just maybe go back into history and tell you that Swanu, as the nationalist party, is the only party in Namibia that was not formed on the tribal basis or on ethnic basis. That's why we don't have necessarily one area or region which is our stronghold, because the whole of Namibia was aimed to be a national country for the national party. And that's why we, as I said earlier, we stuck to our formation criteria, whereby we were represented by all ethnic groups in the country. And this thing of also thinking that Swanu is an elitist party, I think revolutions in the world were led by revolution in the world were led by by educated people, and the whole of the masses of the country, of course, being the base. We strongly believe that if people are educated, then they can lead a successful revolution. And we have failed revolutions in Africa because of uneducated leaders. And that's why in Swanu we encourage that not only the leaders but even the masses and the people of the party and the country be educated, because an educated nation is a self-sufficient and self-reliant nation.
Mm. But what are your aims and objectives in these elections? What do you want to achieve? Do you want to take over the government, or what do you want
we
to achieve?
See ourselves as a government in waiting. Mm-hmm. Of course, because of Namibians being far from understanding yet, maybe currently we may just break the two-thirds majority, which is jeopardizing progress in Namibia. Mm. Because we then negotiate with the ruling party, even in parliament, when you an opposition party brings up a point, a valid point, they outvote it because they have a two-thirds majority. Mm. So this time around, we are trying to do away with that two-thirds majority. But come next elections, we will take over government, because Namibians then will have ripened. They will have better understanding of what Swanu stands for and what it wants to emancipate the entire country totally or completely.
But do you think this thing of the two-thirds majority will be broken by individual parties, or do you think political parties should work together as a collective to break this two-thirds majority?
Whether they work together or whether they work as individuals, still the two-thirds majority has to go, because it has been detrimental to Namibia's progress. Mm. Besides that, all parties coming together is a little bit difficult, because some parties were formed in this country to counter the revolution, and Swanu is a revolutionary party that sticks to its principles and ideology. Mm. So we hope that those who will join us, they are welcome, because ours is to emancipate the Namibian people, for us to enjoy our economy and our land in its full length and breadth.
But how many seats is Swanu targeting in parliament?
Right now we are envisaging, maybe to be realistic, minimum six
seats.
Maximum 10. Mm-hmm. Yes, and because I strongly believe that Namibians have now touched, some of them are touched by the poverty, incumbent poverty, and the majority of them can see that the ruling party has failed. So I believe that they will in mass vote for the party, the only party that is nationalistic, that stands for all Namibians and that wants to emancipate them.
Mm-hmm. And there's this perception that political parties are just fielding members or candidates to go there in parliament as a way of creating job opportunities for their comrades, but not really to address the real issues that are facing the people. What do you have to say on that?
If you remember my predecessor, I think as much as he was alone, the motions and the bills that he brought to parliament were valid, and some of them the government is still working on them. I, for one, since I started, I think you are always at parliament, you have seen what type of criteria or criticism that I bring nationally, not just for Swanu, but for representing all the Namibian people. So for us, that's why we emphasize that issue of education, so that people are educated and we send capable people to parliament who will represent Namibians in all its realms. We are for meritocracy, because we feel that there's no need to just wheelbarrow people to parliament who are just going to be quiet or sit there and support what is not right. We want to send people to parliament that will represent all Namibians in all corners of the country, and will represent them on merit, dealing with critical issues that the government face. The youth especially have to come in very strongly, and very soon we will release our list and you will see that the youth is prominently featured.
Mm-hmm. Yes. All right, so it's not a job opportunity?
No, it's not just, as I said, it's not wheelbarrowing people to seats or to parliament, but credibility, meritocracy, whereby people do what is right for the country. Mm-hmm. Yes.
All right.